Very good morning, students. Myself, L.K. Tripathi from LPM Public School. Dear children, today we have a new video of the new chapter, that is Markets. This is from your civics portion, chapter 8. Today we shall study about the market. First of all, it is essential for us to know about the market. What is market? So, better for us to start this topic. A market is a place or any other kind of arrangement where buyers and sellers exchange goods and services. And this is such a place where people go to buy the things, also to sell the things. And in different form, we can say people exchange the goods and services. Means this is such a thing which fulfill the requirement of both the buyers and sellers. Markets can be physical, that is where buyers and sellers interact while buying and selling things, or even virtual, where buyers and sellers interact through the internet. So this is the place where people, means buyers and sellers, go there, sit together and interact to each other. That is related to buy and selling the goods. Sometimes it is virtual, where buyers and sellers interact through internet. Without physical meeting, they interact to each other through internet and other type of electronic media. How did markets come into being? मार्केट्स कैसे जो है हमारे प्रैक्टिस में आया? लॉन्ग एगो पीपल वेयर हंटर गैदरर्स एंड लेड ए नोमैडिक लाइफ एज दे लर्न फार्मिंग एंड बिगिन टू लेड ए सेटल लाइफ दे सून रियलाइज दैट इट वॉज इम्पॉसिबल to satisfy all their demands themselves. So, a system of exchange of goods started. It is the story of the ancient time when people was hunter-gatherers and they had no any settled life. They were nomadic and lawn farming also began to lead a settled life. After lawn farming, they did not wander, they did not go elsewhere in search of the food. They started a settled life. As they learned farming and began to lead a settled life, they soon realized that it was impossible to satisfy all their demands themselves. And gradually, after settling their life, they thought that it was not possible for them to satisfy all their demands themselves. So, a system of exchange of goods started, where one person produced a particular thing which was exchanged with another necessary things produced by another person. This system of exchange came to be known as the barter system. Barter system means exchange of goods. So this type of system, that was barter system, is started by the early people to purchase the things and sell the things. Gradually, as the necessities of people increase, there was a demand for more and more different kinds of goods and services. This led to the development of specific places where people could buy and sell different types of goods and services. These places were known as markets. Markets can be of different types. Number one, in some markets, people buy and sell particular type of goods in bulk. Such markets are called wholesale markets. In wholesale markets, people buy the goods in bulky way, means in huge way, and that is based on particular type of goods. That is called wholesale markets. Next, in some markets, different shopkeepers sell different kinds of goods and services. Such markets are called retail markets. This is another type of market, that is retail market, where people go to buy the things for their daily use. And such types of markets is known retail market. Retail markets are usually situated in neighborhoods, and majority of buying and selling of the common people take place in the retail market. Next, that is the wholesalers as well as the retailers play the important role of intermediaries in the long and complicated process by which a product reaches from the producer to the market, that is the consumer. So we can say there is deep linkage between wholesalers and retailers. They decide to purchase the things from the wholesaler, means the retailer purchase the goods from the wholesaler, and they decide the rate to sell in the market to the consumer. Let us look at the process in detail. First, Bhanu Singh is a farmer. He grows potatoes in his small field. After the harvest, sometimes he sells his produce directly to a trader who takes it to the mandi or the wholesale market. Sometimes, when the harvest is good, the farmer takes his produce to the mandi directly. Number two, the mandi is a huge place where traders and farmers from villages come to sell their products, while traders from cities come to buy their products. There are storage rooms or godowns of various traders. Sacks of grains are piled up in different places. Number three, the farmer or trader deposits his produce with the mandi samiti, auctioneers. Only registered traders can take part in auctions. Number four, the traders place bids for buying a particular product. Bids are the prices at which the buyer, that is the trader, wishes to buy a product. The trader who bids the highest price gets to buy the product. Number 5, the trader and the farmer have to pay some commission to the Mandi Samiti for their services. Number 6, the trader brings the produce from the mandis to the wholesale market in the city. In these wholesale markets, retailers from all over the city as well as neighboring areas come and buy the products. Next, the retailers sell the products in the neighborhood market. So, the potato that you buy from your neighborhood vegetable seller might have gone through a similar journey. Next, that is problems faced by farmers. What are the problems the farmer faces? In a country like India, where majority of the people are involved in agriculture, farmers have a very important role to play. But a farmer's life is often plagued by many difficulties. First, what are the difficulties? Natural calamities like floods, droughts, and famines can ruin his crop. These are the natural calamities, natural disasters, which often ruin or crush the crops of the farmers. So, they face different types of difficulties due to natural disaster, famine, and other type of natural calamities. As a result, the farmer is left with no harvest to sell. As there is no profit, he has no means to repay the loan he had taken at the beginning of the season to buy his seeds, etc. As a result, farmer always fall in crisis. He has no harvest to sell, no crops to sell for his livelihood to fulfill his other type of necessity. As there is no profit, he has no means to repay the loan he had taken at the beginning of the season to buy his seeds, etc. Thus, the farmer gets entangled in a cycle of debt. In this way, we can say the farmers always get difficulties and engaged in a cycle of debt. Hamesha karz mein duba rehta hai. In many cases, to repay the debt, a farmer has to work as a casual laborer in villages or migrate to cities. And so many cases are there to repay the debt, farmer always go to laborers, casual laborers work as in villages or migrate to city. Next, once the farmer has harvested his crop, he faces the problem of storing it properly. Mostly, storage facilities are not available, and as a result, a huge amount of the harvested crop goes waste, especially if they are perishable goods like fruits. The mandis sometimes do not have basic facilities such as weaving and storage. Sometimes the farmer has to wait for days to get his produce unloaded. In such cases, he is forced to bypass the mandi system and sell to the traders directly at a low price. Farmers also lack access to good fertilizers and good seeds due to ignorance as well as inherent biases. It is important for the government to impart effective education to the farmers so that they can take the help of latest technology and increase the quality and quantity of their harvest. This is very essential for the government to take initiative for the farmers to increase their production and also to get assured that their harvest will be taken at good price. Now, agricultural cooperatives. An agricultural cooperative is an organization of farmers where the farmers pull in their resources in certain areas of activities. It is also known as a farmers cooperative. There are two primary types of agricultural service cooperatives: supply cooperatives and marketing cooperatives. Supply cooperatives provide their members with information regarding agricultural production like seed, chemical, fertilizer, fuel, and other type of things. So we can say that there is intense need for the farmers which the government should take initiative to assure the farmers' interest, farmers' future, and they should be provided good quality fertilizer, seeds, also the harvest or crop which is produced by the farmers should be taken by the government at good price so that the condition of farmer could increase, could maintain, they could fulfill their desire, their requirements in proper way. Because the farmers are the backbone of the Indian economy, and you know very well India is the agriculture based country, so the interest of farmer should be maintained. Thank you.